Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the fifth and final episode to create to-do list using JavaScript. In the previous episode, we learned how to add dynamic buttons like up, down, and remove. And today, we'll make these buttons functional. So, in order to make these buttons functional, we might need to add three click events, one for up, one for down, and one for remove. But instead of adding three click events, we can make use of event delegation. It is used not only to add one event listener for multiple elements, but it also supports when extra child elements are added. Now, let's get started. Open your main.js. While using event delegation, event listener is added to parent element. So in our case, it is list holder div. And then at the top, we have selected list holder div and assigned them in div list variable. So you can use that variable name and then add event listener. Then since it is a click event, you can add click over here. And then you can use a callback function. Let's add event over here, and inside let's add if condition and add event.target.tagName equals button. Now let's create some variables for button, li, and ul. It will be event.target, and then since li is the parent element for this button, let's add button.parentNode. Then for ul, since this is the parent element for li, we can use li.parentNode. Alright, so far we have added click event for the button, but how can we classify which button we are clicking? Is it gonna be up, down, or remove? So to classify them, we can use this class name. So as you can see, each button has got a unique class name, remove, down, and up. So let's use them in another if condition. So add if condition over here. And then to classify the button, we can use button.className equals and a class name. So first we will work on the remove button. So you can copy that class name. And then whenever we click on the remove button, we have to remove li from ul. So we can use ul.removeChild li. Once done, you can then refresh the site, and if you click on this remove icon, the list item will be removed. Great. Now let's add another condition for the down button. So here you can use else if, and then again you can say button.className equals the class name for the down button. So before working on this down button, we first need to get the value of next li. What I mean is, let's assume this keyboard is our current li. Then the first thing we need to do is we need to get the value of next li. So in our case, it would be the headphone. So whenever I click on this down button, this next li should come at top and this current li should come at bottom. So let's do them now. So the first thing is we need to get the value of the next li. So I will call it next li. And to get the value of next li, we can use li.next element sibling. And then we can use the if condition, and whenever there is next ally, we can do you will dot insert before, and then we need to move next ally at top and then our current ally at bottom. So once done, you can refresh the site and then click on this down button, and then it is coming downward. You can see the MacBook. Great. Now let's work on this up button. So again, you can add the else if condition, and here you can add button.classname equals the class name for the up button. Now in terms of this up button, instead of moving the next ally, we have to move the previous ally. So let's do const prev ally equals, so if you want to get the previous ally, then we can use ally dot previous element sibling, and then if there is any previous ally, then this time what we have to do is we have to move this current ally at the top and then previous ally at the bottom. So add current ally at top and then brief ally afterwards. Once done, you can refresh the site, and then let's try to move this headphone up. So click on up, it is going up, click on up. So yeah, click on down, click on up, click on remove. You can add new list item, and it seems everything is working now. Great. This is the end of this final session. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Finally, thank you so much for choosing my YouTube channel to learn JavaScript. I will see you again next time with the next course. If you want some hosting companies, then you can check the link in the description below. Thank you and all the best.